Trail mix is a lightweight and energy-dense food that can be a great pick-me-up when you are playing outside or going on a hike with your family. And with the power of math, we can experiment and discover the best recipes for you. Hi, my name is Ben, and I am an educator at the Lawrence Hall of Science, and I would like to welcome you to our very first episode of Kitchen Science Math Mix. If you're following along at home, you'll need a few things. First, a clean surface to work on, some measuring utensils. I used a cup and a tablespoon. If your ingredients are not bite-sized, you could use a knife to cut them down, and you'll need a bowl to mix it all together. Though, I'm planning on making a lot of trail mix, so I'll need a bigger bowl. We're also gonna need some ingredients. Now, when I make trail mix, I usually use at least one grain product, such as granola or popcorn, one dried fruit, such as this dried mango or raisins, and at least one seed, like these pepitas, a type of pumpkin seed, or a nut, like these walnuts. And you can add something fun too, like these white chocolate chips. Now your ingredients might not be the exact same as mine, and that's okay. You're finding trail mix for you. Take a moment and taste some of the ingredients that you have. Think about what you are tasting, what you're feeling. Is it crunchy? Is it soft? Is it sweet? Is it salty? Does it remind you of butter? Does it remind you of sugar? I wonder what you notice about these and which ones seem like they would make the best trail mix. One thing that I noticed was that when I was eating raw pepitas and I compared them to roasted ones that I roasted myself, the roasted ones were way better. After you do your first taste, it might be helpful to sort your ingredients based on whatever you noticed. Here, I noticed that the mango, the raisins, the granola, and the white chocolate chips tasted very sweet, whereas the seeds, the nuts, and the popcorn were all pretty salty. Or maybe I want to sort by texture. Well, on the left side, I'm gonna put a few things that I felt were softer, chewier, and on the right side, things that are a little more crunchy. And the popcorn's a little bit of both, so I put it near the middle. All right, time for the actual making of our trail mix. Let's get our bowl, then add one tablespoon of each ingredient. It might be hard to get an exact tablespoon of each one because of the different shapes and sizes, but do your best. Then, once you have all of your ingredients, mix well. Then grab a handful, check to see all the ingredients are there, and have a taste. Now, we've just made our very first math mix. You might be wondering what makes this math mix. The secret is we're using ratios. Ratios compare two numbers. Since in this math mix, we have one tablespoon of each ingredient, you could say that we have a 1-to-1 ratio of mangoes to popcorn. You could also compare a single ingredient to all the ingredients. Here's a 1-to-7 ratio of mangoes to all ingredients. This trail mix was way too sweet for me, which makes sense because we had a 4-sweet-to-3 salty ratio. Notice how the 4 for sweet is larger than the 3 for salty. But that's okay. With the power of math, we can fix this. Remove your bowl, clean it, and start again. We want it saltier this time, so we add 1 tablespoon of walnuts, 1 tablespoon of popcorn, and 1 tablespoon of pepitas. Top it off with 1 tablespoon of mango, because I still want a little sweet. Now if we compare our flavors, we should have 1 sweet and 3 salty. Which one's bigger this time? It should be the 3. Therefore, this trail mix should be saltier than sweet. And after tasting it, I liked this one much better. Ratios had already helped me to make a better trail mix. But now I need more. One more time, clean the bowl, but this time we want the big bowl. And a bigger measuring tool. Add a cup of the popcorn, a cup of walnuts, a cup of pepitas, and a cup of mangoes. Now, even though we changed our measuring utensil from a tablespoon to a cup, we still only added 1 scoop of popcorn, one scoop of walnuts, one scoop of pepitas, and one scoop of mangoes. This still leaves us with a 1 sweet to 3 salty ratio. I hope you enjoyed making some math mix with me today. Check out our playlist and subscribe if you want to experience more great science with us at the Lawrence at Home. And if you liked this video in particular, or you're just looking for some more kitchen science videos, be sure to like this video so we know to make more of this kind of content for you. See you around!